Hello everybody, good morning and welcome to the 9th edition of the Paw Print Newscast. As you guys may have noticed, today's Thursday. Why is that, Callie?
Just a reminder that there is no school tomorrow because of parent-teacher conferences.
Yes, 3-day weekend.
And so if you're really interested and you have nothing better to do, tonight we're kicking off this wonderful weekend at 7 p.m. in the auditorium and FCA will be hosting a movie night. Now, Drew, could you tell me a little bit more information on that subject?
I sure can. Actually, I have an interview later in this opening, but I'll just explain a summary of what it was. So the movie is Heaven Is For Real. And along with this, McDonald's will be serving us free ice cream from 6:30 to the start of the movie. And that's like McFlurries, I assume, with M&M's, Oreos.
Best kind of ice cream.
Yes.
And just like you said, Drew had a chance to interview Kaylee Riemann.
Let's go out to me talking to Kaylee. I'm here with Kaylee Riemann, the person in charge of the secret special event on Thursday night. What is this super special event?
It's the FCA movie night.
Woohoo! Free movies! It is free, right?
Yes.
Okay, anybody can come?
Yes.
What is this movie?
This movie will be Heaven Is For Real.
And I can't ask you what that's about because it's kind of spoiling the movie, right?
Yes.
Okay, but there is a secret surprise at this movie. What is that?
It's free McDonald's ice cream, which will be served at 6:30.
Now, the custodian's rumor has been spread around that custodians don't really want the ice cream in the auditorium, but make sure you clean it up, please. It's going to be a hot mess. Well, actually, a cold mess because it's ice cream, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All right, so anybody should go. Do you recommend me going?
Yes, I definitely do.
Should be lots of fun?
Yes.
Hope to see me out there?
Mm-hmm.
I hope to see you out there. I'll be there.
I'll be there, too.
What time?
Movie starts at 7, ice cream at 6:30.
Sounds fun. Thank you, Kaylee.
Yep.
If you guys decide to get picture retakes because your first pictures were not that good, they're now in the office. You guys can pick them up ASAP.
I know that my pictures were a little undesirable, but that's beside the point because we're going to be talking about Interact. And as everybody knows, there's been a new campaign going around called Arrive Alive. And Interact has been posting on social media about these activities. That includes me. Please go like my Instagram.
Please. Give them a shout out. What's your Instagram?
My Instagram, Vincent_Abrams. Thank you. Now, Drew, tell me a little bit more about this Interact.
All right, Vinny. Our very own Kennedy Fagan has had the chance to talk to Missy Vandermark, who works here at the administration building, to learn a little bit more about this Interact campaign. Let's go out to that.
I'm here with Missy Vandermark. Missy, I've seen on Twitter a bunch of things from the Interact that you're interested in and doing. Can you tell me a little bit about those?
We have several things going on right now. If you've seen our social media campaign for Arrive Alive, which is a hashtag that is nationally being shared, we're going to have a selfie frame and just social media campaign for that. We have a State Farm billboard that we're doing. Hopefully you'll see a billboard created by your own peers for State Farm. It'll be geared towards distracted driving. We have an online spirit den that's coming. There's no longer a spirit den at the school. So we're creating an online den that you can shop 24/7, 365 days a year for bath spirit wear. And then we have the West Ohio Food Bank Barrel Drive. They're looking for hygiene items.
Awesome. What is the State Farm campaign? Can you tell me a little bit about it?
The State Farm campaign is a billboard that will be created by our students. There'll be a cash prize that will come to Interact if we would win that. It's actually a contest. And then it'll be a billboard that'll be in our area for distracted driving.
Oh, that sounds awesome. So what kind of items will be donated to the Ohio Food Bank?
They are looking for hygiene items. Typically, West Ohio Food Bank has been canned goods, but the money that they get does not allow them to purchase hygiene items. So we are looking for hygiene items, toothbrushes, deodorants, body wash, bar soap, things of that nature, toothpaste.
Nice. So where can students like take it and bring it into out of the high school?
This is going to be a K through 12 competition by grade level. So for the high school students, you will take it to the high school lobby in the morning, and our Interact members will be there to collect your goods and keep track of what grade brought what items.
Sounds like a nice event to do. So how long is the Spirit Den open for?
That should be up and running hopefully the next week. There'll be a link on our website, and it'll hopefully be open every day.
Awesome. And the last thing, what's your role in the Kyle's Heart Foundation?
Carl Hunlock, the father of Kyle Hunlock, who the Kyle's Heart Scholarship is in memory of, approached us and wanted to do a fundraiser to help put money back into the scholarship fund for our students. So we are organizing a Sunday Fun Day, which will be at Westgate Lanes. It'll be a $15 cost per student. It'll be all the pizza and bowling and pop for 3 hours and a day in February, a Sunday in February.
Sounds like fun. Now back to the studio.
Hey, Vinny.
Hey, Callie.
Since fall sports have ended, can you tell me a little bit about some upcoming winter sports?
Oh, I sure can, Callie. You see, you need to have good grades to be able to participate, and you need to turn those grades into Mr. Jesko. So if you're interested,
let's head on over to sports to learn a little bit more.
Damn mama, I don't wanna sign up. No way, I'll chair again.
Sports
is where
you currently are.
All right, we're starting off with cross country. Had their banquet on Monday, and football's banquet is on Sunday from 1 to 4 in the cafeteria and the auditorium.
Awesome. And the volleyball team had their banquet last Thursday and finished 9th in the WBL. Good job to them.
More on banquets. The boys' soccer banquet is Monday at 7 in the cafeteria, and the girls' soccer banquet is Sunday at 6 in the cafeteria.
The wrestling team had a 5-4 season in the WBO matchup, coming up in fourth place overall last year. This year, they have a new coach, Eric Adkins.
Now to an interview with Colleen and Colin Mell.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with senior wrestler Colin. Colin, this is your fourth year on the wrestling team. Can you tell me some of your goals for this season?
I'd say as a team, our goal is to place pretty high in the WBL tournament, and then individual goals, place sectionals, districts, and then eventually make the state.
Now, I understand you guys have a new coach this year. Can you tell me who that is?
Coach Adkins.
How is he different from past coaches?
He seems to be pretty dedicated and seems to want to push us to our limits.
What are some of your key players that you need to replace this year?
Trey Terry got 6 at state last year. It's big shoes to fill. And then Isaac Ingram is a district placer. Also a pretty tough spot to fill.
When's your guys' first match?
December 2nd at Findlay High School.
All right. Thanks, Colin. Go cheer on the Wildcats December 2nd. Now back to the studio.
Be sure to check out this year's swim cards as well. They're $10, and you can see a swim team member for them or check them out in the literature rack.
Now to the Teacher of the Week with Karis and Lexi, and it's Mr. Dakin.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with Teacher of the Week, new superintendent, Mr. Dakin.
All right, so Mr. Dakin, we are a quarter into the school year so far. Can you tell us some good things you've noticed like throughout this year?
Well, first of all, I'm glad to be a part of this. You guys are awesome. You do a great job, and
Thank
it's one
you.
Of the best things in our district, to be honest with you. But each building is doing a lot of great things, and we're doing a social media promotion in each building. We're on Facebook. Please check us at Bath Local Schools. Hashtag for Twitter is Wildcat Nation. You can check out some great pictures of our students and staff.
Another question, what are some goals that you have for the school?
Goals, really just expand upon what we're doing as a district. We've got great people, great staff, great students, great community. Again, social media is one of those to promote our kids, promote our teachers, our programs. We're gonna try to bring back the Bath Boosters, an athletic group that hopefully can promote our facilities or make our facilities even better. We're going to start a Wildcat Hall of Fame starting next year to try to gain more pride in our community and recognize those people that come before us.
That'd be nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I like that Hall of Fame idea. Mm-hmm. All right, so for the final questions, are there like any future plans that you'd like to see implement into Bath as like a district?
Mm-hmm. Well, that's a great question. In my first year, I'm just trying to get a hold of what we're doing as a district. I've been here 21 years. I went to school here. Believe it or not, I've been about 40 years here at Bath Schools. But this is a chance to analyze what we're doing in curriculum, and I'm really excited to try to implement a career path program where kids in sixth grade start targeting more specific ideas, expose them to local industry, local jobs, Apollo, career paths with college education. we're trying to just target and narrow down and try to help parents and families make decisions better about what their future holds.
Mm-hmm. That's great, yeah, starting them young. Well, there you have it, new superintendent, Mr. Jackin. Thank you.
Thank
you. Now to the halls of the polls.
I met you in the dark, you lit me up, you made me feel as though I was...
Alright, I'm here with Sam, and Sam, since there's so much stress in this world, what does a day with no stress look like to you?
I go home, eat, watch YouTube, and go to sleep.
That is my daily life.
Kaylin, what do you do to de-stress during the day?
I would have to say, lay in my bed, and chill, and just watch some movies.
Sounds like a good day.
I'm my boy Armando, and Armando, what stresses you out the most?
Probably school.
That's the answer everybody says. Thank you.
I'm here with Zach, and I was wondering, does your foot stress you out since you had surgery on it?
No.
Not at all?
No.
So then what does stress you out?
Clowns.
Clowns stress you out? Why?
They're really creepy.
I have to agree with that one. All right, so are you stressed?
Yeah, all the time.
Okay, so Alex, tell me, what does a day with no stress seem like to you?
A day where probably Jake Paul comes to my house and he just talks to me all day.
It's every day, bro. I'm here with Delaney, and I was wondering, what stresses you the most?
Nothing really.
No stress at all?
Mm-hmm.
And I wish I could be like you.
I'm with my boy Tyler, and Tyler, what stresses you out the most?
School.
I'm here with Chris, and what stresses you?
Not much, really.
Living the dream.
Librarian Ms. Bergman, what happens to stress you out the most?
People with no common sense.
Yes.
I'm here with Nate. Nate, what makes you stressed?
Caden Schmidt.
Same.
So I'm here with Anita. Anita, are you stressed?
Yeah, just a little bit.
So what would a day with no stress be like to you?
Sleeping all day.
Man, I love sleep.
Katie, what stresses you the most? Homework.
Taste.
Yes.
Same.
I'm here with Natalie, and what is a typical stress-free day like for you?
Staying home in my pajamas and watching TV.
Those are the good days.
Leah and Leo, what stresses you the most?
Schoolwork.
Same.
Freshman Kayla, what happens to stress you the most?
Grades.
Yeah, those are very stressful.
I'm here with fellow senior Jake Klingler. And Jake, what stresses you the most?
Homework.
I feel you on that one.
What happens to stress you the most?
Probably not being able to drink water.
Water's pretty good.
Good morning, BHS. Welcome to Getting Ready with Vincent, part two. Like I said last week, we meet back here. Well, as we all know, I'm a little bit of a student athlete, and I like to keep in shape by eating a healthy, nutritious lunch. And first off, I was thinking about making a Pop-Tart. Let's just open that real quick. Oh, cherry pop, those are Cheetos. Cheetos, no, paprika. Paprika and Pop-Tarts. You know, if you get the spice, it'll really waken up your immune system. You guys gotta lick it off and you're like, yeah. So there's that, paprika and Pop-Tarts. Second, I was thinking about getting a bologna sandwich because you have to have protein in your diet. Oh, and a banana. Potassium is very important. And you got a microwave banana. You got a microwave banana with the, yes. You leave it in there for about 30 seconds.
3 hours later.
Can you move it along? I'm all out of time cards.
I eat my sandwich. I don't know why I torture myself on camera. And a little dessert of marshmallows. I got a few. Top it off. And honey, I want honey. It's past the microwave by the Cheetos. By the, right where my head's pointing hands. Right there, right in front of me. Right there, right? Now let's get some honey in here. Pour some sugar on me, baby. Oh, right here, right there. And now we get Get it all over the face. It's a nice moisturizer. I gotta rub it in there. Rub it in there. Rub it in your hands. Thank you. Mm-hmm. It makes a good shaving cream too. Look at this one. Oh. Thank you. Well, this has been getting, well, having lunch with a student athlete at Bath High School. Have a good week, BHS. See you next week.
I'm here with Mr. Markley. Please enlighten us with your wisdom.
This week's motivational moment comes from the GOAT. A lot of people who aren't so blessed with talent are the most competitive and have the biggest heart. Tom Brady, the GOAT.
Wow, what a guy.
Everybody look alive, say come on, come on, come on. We're gonna get it now. Hands up if you're ready for the fight.
I'm with Keaton Jubilant Jordan, a freshman here at Bath High School. We're gonna play a little bit of a game. Is that okay with you?
Yeah.
Alright, so I'm going to ask you a few superhero questions. Question number one. What city does Batman defend?
Gotham.
Gotham. That was correct. I forgot to explain the rules. We're going to give you a handshake for every correct answer. Yes, sir. Next question. What is the Red Skull's nationality?
German. Yeah, German.
Yes, sir. And then the last question. Can you name me one Spider-Man villain?
Dark Arc.
That's it. That's 3 for 3.
I'm here with fellow classmate Justin Klinger. Justin, I'm going to ask you a couple of superhero trivia questions. Is that cool?
Yeah.
All right. Who is Steve Rogers?
Captain America.
That's correct. Now, who is Thor's brother?
Loki.
Man, 2 for 2 on this. Oh, right now. 2 for 2 on the spot. Nice.
I'm here with Ashton Baker. And Ashton, I'm going to ask you a bit of superhero trivia. If you get 1 out of 2 right, I'm going to give you a firm handshake. All right?
Sounds good.
All right, what is Green Lantern's real name?
Hal Jordan.
That's correct. What is the name of Iron Man's significant other?
Pepper Potts?
That's correct as well. Nice job, my friend.
I'm with Micah Courageous Cox. And Micah, we're going to play a game today, and that game constitutes superhero trivia. If you get one right, you get a handshake. If you don't get one right, I'm sorry. Question one. Who is the villain in the Batman universe who froze his wife, whose name is Nora, and last name is spelled F-R-I-E-S-E?
Mr. Freeze.
That's a handshake. The second question, who's the Batman villain who uses a coin to decide your fate?
Two-Face.
That's right. Got some toughies on this one.
I'm here in Steven. We're going to play some superhero trivia. Is that cool?
Yep.
All right, I'm going to ask you 2 questions. If you get one of them right, I'll give you a firm handshake.
Okay.
All right, we're going to start off with Marvel. Name me one of Spider-Man's girlfriend's name.
Mary Jane Watson.
That's correct. Now we're going to head over to the DC side. Batman has a nickname. What is that?
The Caped Crusader.
That works.
Here with Carson, my man. All right, Carson, are you willing to play a little game here?
Yes.
All right, I'm going to ask you 2 superhero questions. If you get one right, I'll give you a firm handshake. If you get 2 right, I'll give you a pat on the back, okay?
You already gave me the second one.
Okay. All right, so first question. What is the name of the Winter Soldier in Captain America?
Bucky Barnes.
That's correct. All right, now what is the name of Joker's girlfriend?
Harley Quinn.
That's correct. Nice job, my friend.
Hit me with a tough one next time. Come on.
I am here with my sister, and she is Student of the Week this week. And Erica, how are you liking it here at BHS so far?
It's a lot better than middle school.
And why is that?
Because the teachers are so much better.
Now, I'm supposed to know this, but they don't know it. What kind of sports? What sports do you play here at BHS?
I did soccer. I'm in swim, and I'm going to do track.
Which one do you like the most?
Swim.
And why is that?
Because it's really fun.
It's really fun. You heard it here.
All right, Erica. Now I have a big question here. What is your favorite subject, and who is your favorite teacher here at BHS?
My favorite subject is math, and then my favorite teacher is Mr. Steidel.
All right, I have a crazy one for you. You wake up at 3 a.m. and you're really hungry. What's the first thing you'd grab out of your fridge as a snack?
An ice cream sandwich.
All right, now, what is your favorite animal?
A giraffe.
One final question. What is your favorite fall vegetable?
A pumpkin.
Pumpkins are really nice. Now, out to the weather.
Hello, I'm Nate Gast, and welcome to Custom Audio Concepts. We have all different types of electronic solutions for all your electronic needs, but today in particular, there are a couple of things that I would like to show you. One would be the wide variety of car audio that we have, so whether or not you just need to replace the deck in your car, or you need to replace the entire system, including subwoofers, we have a number of different choices to make that be the right solution for you. Then secondly, we have a number of different remote starts that I'd like to show you. And the remote starts can be anything from something that would tie into your key, where you can press the key up into something that allows you to use your phone to dial back to your car to tell it to start. So at Custom Audio Concepts, once again, we fit all your electronic needs, and be sure to stop in and see us between Payless Shoes and the Umatu Grill on Elida Road. Thank you. Before the thunder.
Singing, follow me, everything is alright. I'll be the one to tuck you in.
Hi guys, Will, come on up, dude.
Sorry.
We're here with the weather. Will, start them off. We got a three-day weekend, so we got to do four weathers. What's Thursday?
All right, starting off on Thursday, we have a high of 47, a low of 24, and it is going to be mostly sunny.
The sun might help, but that's still kind of chilly. For Friday, we got a high of 33 and a low of 22, and it's mostly, that's actually full sunny. So there might not be snow, but that is cold, dude. What do we got for Saturday?
On Saturday, it warms up a bit, 42, a low of 36. It's going to be cloudy, though, so it still might be a little chilly, maybe some wind there.
That's going to be freezing, dude. Coats for sure.
For sure. Sunday, Drew. Go on Sunday.
Sunday is a high of 46, the highest of the weekend weather, and a low of 35, but it is unfortunately going to have PM showers, so wear an umbrella. You don't wear umbrellas, but grab an umbrella and go outside if you want to go outside. I wouldn't. It's only 46, low 35. It's kind of cold. But
thanks for joining us on the weather.
Yeah, let's go.
Hamburg pickle on top makes your heart go flippity flop.
Have you had your QP today?
You need to stay up out in the streets if you can't take the heat. You need to stay up out in the streets if you can't take the heat. Cause it get cold.
And that concludes this edition of the Paw Print Newscast.
Interact Club will be in the cafeteria Thursday and Friday to take pledges for their hashtag Arrive Alive.
They'll bring their selfie frame, so go get a bunch of pictures with your friends.
Yep. And for a reminder, the Interact Barrel Drive starts Monday.
They're collecting personal hygiene items. Emily, can you tell me what those are?
Like deodorant, toothbrush, toothpaste, perfume, cologne, anything hygiene.
That's right. And just a reminder, the final trip for payments for band and choir are due today, so make sure you get those turned in.
Yep, and Saturday, there will be the Bath PTS Purse Bingo.
That is at 11 in the morning and it's open to anybody in the whole community.
Yep, and it's also in the high school gym. And that brings this ninth edition of the Paw Print Newscast to a close.
Thank you all for watching, and enjoy your not one,
not two,
but 3-day weekend.
You need to stay up out in the streets if you can't take the heat. You need to stay up out in the streets if you can't take the heat. Cause it get cold like Minnesota. Cold like Minnesota. Cold like Minnesota. Cold like Minnesota. Need to stay up out in the streets if you can't take the heat. You need to stay up out in the streets if you can't take the heat. Cause it get cold like Minnesota. Cold like Minnesota. Cold like Minnesota, it get cold like Minnesota. Need to stay up out the streets if you can't take the heat. You need to stay up out the streets if you can't take the heat. Cause it get cold like Minnesota. Riding around on boaters. Money sitting up, it sit way above your shoulders. I was eating pork and rinds.
What happens to stress you the most?
That you just said what happens to stress you the most.
Pictures. Pictures. I'm in Garland. Picture day.
So are you going to say
not
something?
Not included for a reason.
No, I just wanted to say it.
Okay. This is an A-B conversation, so see your way out of here.
Oh my god. You 100%
can hear
that mouth.
Never been so good.
So good. So,
so good.
Good. I'm
going to
tell them
so
to be
good.
Quiet.
I don't know. What do you want to do now? Wait, what do you want to
do? Just do something, Mel.
Do something. What do you want?
I understand you guys have a new coach. Can you tell me who that is?
Coach Atkins.
Are you ready? Thanks, guys.
Oh, my God. Hey, we're trying to work back here. How hard is it, Trey?
Oh. So I'm supposed to be like out here? That looks dumb.
That looks dumb.
Is it gone? The present has no ribbon.
Do you want to trade?
Just say a different word.
And that concludes this edition.